Today we are going to discuss the topic, one of the important topics, solutions. Solutions, generally in JE mains, we can expect one question from the solutions every year. So today, initially we discuss some basic definitions of the solution. Let us see what are those basic definitions. The meaning of the solution is basically, it is a homogeneous mixture of two or more components. So solution, basically it is a homogeneous mixture of two or more components. Let us discuss about each and every word in this definition. I'll take an example. If I take water, we know the molecular formula of the water, that is H2O. Let us take the water in a beaker. I am taking the two beakers over here. Imagine water is present in both of these beakers. This is the first beaker A, this is the beaker B. Now we know that the water is present here, its molecular formula is H2O. Here also water is present, whose molecular formula is H2O. If only one chemical component substance is present, such type of the combinations are called as simply compound, or since water is a liquid, it is called as simply pure liquid. Water is not called as a solution because only one component is present. It is simply called as a pure liquid. Now let's try to add some salt to this water. We know the salt molecular formula, which is NaCl. Now after the addition of the NaCl to the H2O, now this particular beaker will have the two chemical components. What are those? NaCl and H2O. So when NaCl is added to the H2O, we simply call it as a mixture. It is called as a mixture. Now let's try to add sand, whose molecular formula is SiO2, to the beaker B. Now after the addition of the sand to the another beaker B, again here two chemical components are present, and this is also called as a mixture. Now the question is whether these two mixtures are same or not. Even though chemical combination wise they are different, but physical combination wise whether they are same or different. Let us see. After the addition of the NaCl to the water, we know that NaCl usually present in the solid state, so I'll put it as a S in parenthesis, and H2O, we know that it is present in the liquid state, and here SiO2 is also a solid and H2O is a liquid. So the moment NaCl is added to the water, H2O, which is in the liquid state, NaCl completely gets dissolved into the H2O, and it is uniformly distributed throughout the volume of the solution. And after a certain time, we cannot find any physically present NaCl in this mixture, because NaCl is completely gets dissolved, and we can see it just like it appears like a water only, but you cannot find NaCl separately over here, because this NaCl completely gets dissolved, and this is a mixture. But after the addition of this NaCl to the water, we are able to see only one type of the physical state chemical compound, but not the both, because it is uniformly distributed throughout the volume of the liquid. Such type of the mixtures where we are not able to distinguish the two chemical components separately, and uniform physically appearance only, uniform physical appearance is there, such type of the mixtures are called the homogeneous mixtures. So homogeneous mixtures are the one where they will have the only single physical state and uniform distribution of the both the compounds are present, and we cannot distinguish both the components in that particular combination. So such type of the mixtures are called the homogeneous mixtures. Now come to the other beaker B here. The moment we add the sand, we know that sand do not dissolve into the water. Simply, it gets deposited at the bottom of the beaker. Means after the addition of this sand, and if you keep it for long time also, you will find the sand always at the bottom of the beaker, and we can easily distinguish sand and the water even after the addition of the sand to the water. So physically sand still present here, but here physical state of the NaCl do not present, means NaCl do not retain its physical state after the addition to the water, but sand retains its physical state in the form of the solid. So we can easily distinguish sand from the water. Though it is a mixture, but this sand is not dissolved or not distributed throughout the volume of the H2O. So this type of the mixtures are called the heterogeneous mixtures. So heterogeneous mixtures we don't discuss. We discuss only about the homogeneous mixtures. So basically solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more components. So at least two components must be present. When two compounds are present, they may be present in the same quantity or they may be present in the different quantity. That's why we have to name them differently. Now let us take the two other names, that is solvent and solute. So what does it mean by the solvent? It is the larger quantity substance present in the solution. And one more thing, the physical state of the physical state of the solvent is same as that of the solution. We shall discuss where we have to use the first sentence and where we can use the second sentence separately. Similarly, solute, it is the smaller quantity substance present in the solution. And the second definition is the physical state of this solute is not same as, means it's different, is different from the solution. Let us see where we can use these two sentences at the same time, these two sentences. And when again we have to come to the first example. So in the first example, we know that NaCl is in the solid state, H2O is in the liquid state. And quantities I did not mention here. Now let us come here, then we go back again to the beaker A. So according to the first one, it is the larger quantity substance present in the solution, that is called the solvent. So this particular sentence is applicable where both solute as well as the solvent are present in the same physical state. So here let us take, imagine example, you add 50 grams of sugar to the 100 ml of water. We know that for water, the density is 1 ml is equals to 1 gram, because density equals to 1 gram for 1 ml. So you can consider it as 100 grams. But let us take H2O since it is present in the liquid state, standard state. So we take it as 100 ml. So when 50 grams of sugar is added to the 100 ml of the H2O, so mass wise, if you imagine that H2O is in the larger quantity and sugar is in the smaller quantity. So that we can say that sugar is the solute and H2O is the solvent. So sugar is the solute and H2O is the solvent. Sorry, I said that both are both must be present in the same physical state. No, okay, we'll take the another example. This is applicable to the second one. So we take another example to the first one. Imagine 50 ml of ethyl alcohol, which is present in the liquid state, is added to the 100 ml of H2O. Both are present in the liquid state. So 50 ml of ethyl alcohol and 100 ml of the H2O. Both are in the liquid state, and once you add ethyl alcohol to the water, we cannot distinguish which is ethyl alcohol and which is water, because it is completely miscible in the water. So that's why here we have to identify them just by quantity. So 50 ml of ethyl alcohol and 100 ml of the water. So this is in the larger quantity. So it is called as the solvent. And this is in the smaller quantity, which is called as a solute. Now come to the second one here. The physical state of the solvent is same as that of the solution. So here I have taken, though when you compare the quantities, 50 grams, 100 ml, when you compare, this is a larger quantity solvent and this is a smaller quantity solute. But second one is, if you take 500 kg of sugar, just imagine, only assumption, though it is not possible usually. So just imagine 500 kg of sugar is added to the H2O. Is it possible to dissolve 500 kg of the sugar in just 100 ml of the water? It is not possible, just assumption only, because we have to define this definition. So 500 kg of the sugar is added to the 100 ml of the H2O, even though the 500 kg is dissolved. Then which is a solvent? This is a solvent, because H2O is retaining its physical state in the liquid state. Before the addition of the sugar, it is in the liquid state. Even after the addition of the sugar also, it is in the liquid state. So according to this definition, the solvent is the one which retains its physical state, and solute is the one which do not retains its physical state. So here, if it is able to dissolve in 100 ml of the H2O, it is called as the solvent. And this is called the obviously solute. So solute solvent definitions not only to be defined just based on the quantity, even based on their physical states. The one that retains its physical state after the addition of the two components is called the solvent, and which do not retain and completely loses its physical state and going into the other one is called as always solute. So this is about just basic thing. So from this it is very clear that solvent and solute not only present in the solid state, they may present in the different states. So this solvent may be present in the, it may be present in the solid, or it may be present in the liquid, or it may be present in the gaseous state. Similarly, the solute is also may present in the solid state, or it may be present in the liquid state, or it may be present in the gaseous state. So based on the combination of the physical states of both the solute and the solvent, and we are going to get almost 9 type of the solutions. Now let's going to discuss those 9 type of the solutions. If the solid is the solvent in any solution, they are called the solid solutions. If liquid is the solvent, it is called the liquid solution. If gas is the solvent, they are called the gaseous solutions. So the name of the solution comes after the physical state of the solvent, not on the physical state of the solute, because solvent is in the larger quantity and which only maintains its physical state after the addition of the two compounds. Now, let us see the solid solutions. So, solid solutions means, it means that the solvent is the solid here. Solute, solute may be solid, liquid or gas. So, we shall take here, this is solute, here it is solvent. Let us take an example here. So, since we are discussing about the solid solutions, solvent is always solid only. So, solid, solid and solid. Solute may be solid. Solute may be liquid. And a solute may be gas. So, when solute is solid, solvent is also solid. So, when solid-solid combination is able to be the homogeneous mixture, generally people may think that, is it possible that two solids get mixed homogeneously? It is possible. We have seen the, we know that 22 carats of the gold, which is not the pure gold, which contains certain amount of the copper. So, once a copper is added to the gold, they completely mixed up and we are not able to distinguish where copper is present, because copper completely mixed to the gold and it appears like gold only. So, here gold is the solvent, copper is the solute. So, combination of the metals is called the solid in solid type of the solutions. Best example, alloys. Alloys. Next, liquid in solid. If liquid is added to the solid, we get liquid in solid type of the solution. Earlier one is solid in solid type of the solution. The example is alloys. And if liquid is added to the solid, we get liquid in solid type of the solution. And example, again here doubt arises. How the liquid dissolves into the solid? It is possible. We know that mercury is present in the liquid state, though it is a metal. And sodium, zinc, iron, magnesium, these are all present in the metals, present in the solid state. So, when mercury is added to the sodium, they completely mixed up and they produce a combination which is called as sodium amalgam. So, whenever any metal is added to the mercury, that combinations are called as the amalgams. If sodium is added, it is called the sodium amalgam. If zinc is added, it is called a zinc amalgam. If iron is added to the mercury or mercury is added to the iron, it is called the iron amalgam. So, amalgams are the combination of the metals where one is always mercury, the other one differs. It depends. So, here the example is zinc mercury, which is called a zinc amalgam. You can take sodium amalgam, iron amalgam, any combination. And gas in solid. So, if gas is dissolved into the solid state, solid, that combination is called a gas in solid type of the solutions. So, best example is in organic chemistry, we used to use hydrogen palladium, hydrogen nickel, hydrogen platinum combinations. Means, if you just imagine this is the hydrogen, this is the metal, means a nickel, platinum or palladium. If hydrogen gas is exposed or placed over the, or it, if hydrogen gas is passed over the surface of the any of these metals are having the very active surfaces and they absorb that hydrogen over their surface. So, hydrogen is present in the over the surface of the metal, but it looks like a solid only. But though the gas is present, so it is called as the homogeneous mixture, because we cannot identify where hydrogen is present. It is called the hydrogen, means gas in solid type of the solutions. So best example is hydrogen on palladium or platinum or nickel surfaces. Now let us see the second type of the solutions, which are called the liquid solutions. So liquid solutions, here which is the solvent? Liquid. Here solid solution, solvent is solid. So here solvent is liquid only. Then what about the solute? Solute again may be same combination. It may be a solid, it may be a liquid, it may be a gas. Now just you see here, if a solid is dissolved in the liquid, that is called the solid and liquid type of the solution. Just normal solution, we have just dissolved the salt in the water, salt solution, sugar solution, these are all. So I'll take the example salt solution, where salt is dissolved into the water. If liquid is added to the another liquid and we get the liquid in liquid type of the solutions, I have taken the example of combination of the ethyl alcohol plus water. This is called as alcoholic solution. If gas is dissolved into the liquid, we get the gas in liquid type of the solutions. Best example is carbonated water. Where can we see this carbonated water? I think you are all aware of the beverages, cool drinks, soda. How these are made up of? Simply they take the water and they dissolve the carbon dioxide in that. Most of the gases are dissolved into the water. So the carbon dioxide, once dissolved into the water, immediately they seal it so that the carbon dioxide shall not come out. The moment when you open the bottle, the carbon dioxide comes with effervescence, the sound, hiss makes sound. So from where it is coming means it was already dissolved into the water. So once the carbon dioxide is dissolved into the water, so it is a gas in liquid type of the solutions. So gas in liquid. Now let us take another combination, gaseous solutions. This is the third one. So gaseous solutions means here the solvent is, we know that, gas. So solvent is always gas and the solute may be solid, liquid or a gas. So if a solid is dissolved in the gas, we get solid in gas type of the solution. Is it possible that a solid dissolves into the gas and makes a homogeneous mixture? Yes, it is possible. We might have seen that dust particles, very minute dust particles, are the smoke, carbon particles, they get distributed throughout the air. And we see just air and we are not able to identify that dust particles are the carbon particles, because it looks like air only, because it is a homogeneous mixture. But still two combinations, gas and solid particles, still are present. So such is, that is called the solid in gas type of the solutions. And example for this is a dust in gas. Dust particles in gas. And what about the liquid in gas? It is very easy that we know that smallest droplets, when you go morning time, we can see that more moisture is present in the air. From where it is coming means the small water droplets, it is called a mist. Small water droplets are distributed throughout the air, but you cannot see them, but you feel it once it means deposits on your skin. So we can feel, but we cannot observe, because it looks like a homogeneous mixture. So it is called as a liquid in gas type of the solutions. And example is moisture. And gas in gas. mixture of the gases. Nitrogen, hydrogen, whatever the atmospheric gases, whatever is present, all are present. One, nitrogen is present in the larger quantity, next oxygen, next like the argon, all these are present. So combination differs, but still they are all gases. So we cannot identify which is nitrogen gas, which is hydrogen gas, which is oxygen gas, because it's a homogeneous mixture. So that is called a gas in gas type of the solutions. Best example is mixture of the gases. So these are the examples of different solutions: solid solutions, liquid solutions, and gaseous solutions. In our syllabus, we have only two things: liquids in liquid type of the solutions, solid in liquid. Together it is a liquid solutions. We have liquid solutions. So solid in liquid type of the solutions we discuss. Liquid in liquid type of the solutions also we discuss, and a gas in liquid type of the solutions. We discuss only some conditions like pressure and how the gas, which conditions are helpful it to dissolve more amount of the gas into the liquid. So basically we have the liquid solutions in our syllabus. Solid solutions, gaseous solutions, we do not discuss. And moreover, and in all these combinations we are seeing one is the solute, one is the solvent. And then solutions may have how many number of the chemical components? A solution may have more than two also. At least two must be present. More than two also present. The solution that is having at least two chemical components in it, it is called the binary solution. So these are all whatever we have discussed. These are all binary solutions. Binary means two. The solution with two combinations. Binary solutions. What other things we can learn from the solutions? We know that solution is a combination of solute and solvent. So that we will write one thing that here. So solution means solution equals to, it is a combination of solute plus solvent. So solution is coming from the combination of both of these. So when the mass of the solute and mass of the solvent is added, obviously we get the solution. So mass of the solution is equals to the mass of the solute plus mass of the solvent. You must remember this one. Why? Because this helps while we derive the relation between the molality and molarity. And one more thing, the mole fraction of the solution is equals to the mole fraction of the solute plus mole fraction of the solvent. So these are all we have to remember in solving the problems. And I hope that you understand this introduction part. And in the next video, we shall discuss the methods of concentration. Thank you.